That's exactly how I would have hit it.
That center.
I predict an eagle for this hole.
Meet Hafdis, Rangvig, and Margaret. Aside from beating me in a game of golf on a balmy 29-degree day, these women are all CEOs, one of them the former head of their Food and Drug Administration. They're part of a generation of Icelandic women inspired by the election of President Vigdis.
I think Iceland is the best country to be a female in the world.
There has been a lot of changes the last maybe 15 to 20
years. And we've gone like that.
Yeah. We have the same chance as the men.
You do.
Yeah, definitely.
You do feel that in your bones.
Yes, in your bones. We grow up believing that. I mean, we don't even think about it.
We have a gender quota for the biggest companies.
Yeah. You mean the company's board of directors?
Yeah.
So you have to be either 40%, at least 40% women or 40% men. Because you also have to think about the young men. They need to get on the boards also. So it's a good law for them also.
Right. Yeah. So it can't be more than 60% women.
Yeah.
No.
That's true. Yeah.
Research has shown us that, and this is international research, that once you have three women in the boardroom, that's when culture starts changing. Not when you have one or two, because one is a token and two is a minority. But once you have three, it all of a sudden changes the group dynamics. It changes how the dialogue is taken, what is discussed. And it's been well shown that that goes beyond the balance sheet when you have more women around the table. They start asking more about all stakeholders. And this is what I call a different moral and ethical compass. And I think this is extremely valuable today. And I actually don't think you can survive long-term in business without doing this today.
Throughout my invasions, it was clear that where women had power and were true equals, people were simply better off. Yet here in Iceland, I felt that the women had taken this to an even higher level.